And welcome to ASL Basics with Miss Colleen. I recommend this program for children ages 6 and up, however you're never too early or too late to start learning a new language. Before we begin, let's go ahead and stretch out our fingers. Remember, you don't want to push them too far because you don't want it to hurt. Shake them out. Rub them together and warm them up if they're a little bit cold. It's starting to get chilly outside. And let's go ahead and begin. Today's topic, we are going to be talking about animals. The sign for animal is to take those bent open B's, place them right beneath your shoulders, right around your shoulder blade area, and just kind of wiggle back and forth. Animals. Animal. Animal. Now when we're doing these signs for animals, the main goal is to use our hands to try to describe a very distinct feature of the animal. So whether it's something like a big long nose, like an elephant, where you would just swoop and show that nose, or whether it's the way they walk, like a penguin, where you straighten out your arms and walk forward. So we're trying to show certain characteristics of an animal that makes it clear what animal we're talking about. Now, of course, there are still plenty of animals that are very similar, and sometimes you might need to fingerspell the animal and then do the sign just so that it's clear to the person you are signing to. But today we are going to focus on some of our domestic animals. So let's start with our pets. The sign for pet, you're just going to make a fist and then kind of pet it like you're petting your dog or cat's head. Pet. 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 For dog, there's two signs that I'm going to show you. The first is to just pat your hip or your thigh, like you're calling your dog to you. The other one is to kind of snap your fingers together right in front of you. So you can see I'm just taking my middle finger and my thumb and kind of snapping them. Some of you might snap when your dog's misbehaving. It also is very similar to the way we spell dog, where we go from D, O, to a G. So if you do it really fast, you kind of end up doing that same motion. So you just turn it on your side for dog, or just dog. For a cat, you're going to take an F right around your nose and pretend like you are stroking some whiskers. You can also do this with the number 8 or with the letter G. Either way, you're talking about a cat, no matter which way you do it. For a rabbit, you're going to take two U's and you're going to cross them and then just let them kind of twitch at the tips, like the ears of a rabbit. Rabbit. You can also do them on your own head. Take your palms and face your palms back away from the person you're signing to and make that same kind of ear twitch motion. Rabbit or bunny. Make sure when you do this that you do it with the back of your hand facing the person you're signing, because if you do it with your palms facing the person you're signing, it takes on some different meanings. So either bunny or rabbit, either one. For bird, just take your thumb and index finger and you're just going to mimic a beak. Bird. Bird. For a fish, take that open B, lay it on its side, and just let your fish swim forward. Fish. This picture is specifically of a goldfish, so for that, we would do our color gold. Remember, touch our ear and shake a Y out to the side for yellow. Gold fish. Gold fish. And then for a mouse, you're just going to take an index finger and kind of brush it against the tip of your nose. Mouse. If you're talking about a rat, just change it to an R and brush that on the tip of your nose. Rat. So those are a couple of animals that you guys might have as pets. Some animals that you might see around your house, or maybe you have them for pets, are reptiles. There's not an actual specific sign for reptile. For the most part, you're just going to fingerspell it, R-E-P-T-I-L-E. But I have seen a suggested sign, which is to take your index finger and then place your non-dominant hand over your wrist and kind of shake or wiggle it back and forth like the movement of a reptile's tail. Again, this isn't quite an official sign. For the most part, you're going to see it spelled out. Our first one that we have is snake. So you're going to bend a V, kind of like a snake's fangs, and then you're just going to slither it forward like a snake. Some people might start from their mouths and go out. Some people might just start down at their waist and go up. Either way, snake. For an alligator or a crocodile, they have the same sign. So this is one of those animals that you're going to want to spell out to tell them if you are specifically talking about an alligator or a crocodile. So for that, we're going to claw our hands and we're going to open them wide, like the mouth of a crocodile or an alligator, and we're gonna snap them shut. Crocodile or alligator. Let's get those big jaws in there. For a frog, you're going to make a fist under your chin. Just let your chin rest on your knuckles, and you're going to flick out your index and middle finger. Like this, kind of like when we did the number 12. Remember, we flicked it out. So you're going to do that just under your chin. Frog. Frog. Lizard is another one. There are a whole bunch of different kinds of lizards. So for the most part, you're just going to see that finger spelled along with what kind of lizard it is. So mostly you'll just see L-I-Z-A-R-D. Lizard. Some suggested signs for that is to take the sign for snake and run it up your arm, or to take an L and run that up your arm. But again, those are just suggestions. You will mostly see it spelt. Lizard. For a turtle, take your A hand shape and lay it on its side, and then cover it with your non-dominant hand and your thumb is the head of your turtle, and your non-dominant hand is its shell. So, turtle. Turtle. Those are just a couple of reptiles. Now, some farm animals. So, the sign for farm, you're going to take a four and drag it under your chin. Farm, and then do that sign for animal. Animals. Farm, animal. Farm animals. First, we have a cow. For that, you're going to pretend like you have horns, take a Y, place it right at your temple, and you give it a twist. Cow. You might see this done with both hands if someone's telling a story, but if you're just talking about the animal in general, you can just do one hand. Cow. Bull is a little bit different. We still use that Y hand shape. But for that, you can do two things for bull. Take that Y, and you can place the back of your hand on your forehead, bull, or you can roll your knuckles along your forehead, bull, bull. So whichever way, whether you do the back of your hand or your knuckles, it's a sign for bull. For a horse, you're going to take a U and open it. Place your thumb right at your temple, and then kind of flick your ear forward like the ear of a horse. 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 For a pig, we're going to, again, place our chin on top of the back of our hand, and then kind of flick it inwards. Pig. Pig. This is also the sign that we use for dirty, because pigs are very messy, right? Pig. For a sheep, take a V, and you're going to cut and pretend like you are shearing wool off of your arm. You know, farmers take those big, big shearing scissors and they cut off the wool of the sheep so that they can see better. Sheep. Sheep. For goat, you're going to take that bent V again and touch it to your chin and then your forehead. Goat. Think of the little beard that the goats have right at their chin, and then those horns on their head that go back. Goat. For chicken, you're going to take that sign for bird, and you're going to peck in an open palm like you're picking up some corn or some chicken feed off the ground. If you're talking specifically about a rooster, you can take the number 4 and kind of roll it on top of your head, like that little red thing that they have. So rooster. You can also do it with the number 3, rooster, and chicken. And then finally for duck, you're going to take that squished C. Remember, this is our letter C and we squish it. And just like with bird, you're going to place it in front of your mouth and move it up and down, kind of like you're quacking. Quack, quack, quack. So, duck. Because they have much thicker bills than a little bird's beak, right? So, duck. So, those are all of the animals for this video. In part 2 of animals, we will cover some more wild animals and ocean animals, ones that you may not necessarily see in your home or just out and about, ones that you might have to go to a zoo or an aquarium to see. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and YouTube for more updates. Go to cctexas.com/library to access our online catalog, see a full list of all of our virtual programs, and check out our online browsing feature with the new book alerts, author check, and the book newsletter. And I hope to see you guys again for part 2. Bye!